Hey everyone, Demon Knight here. In this video I want to go over all team boosts as well as team related skills in Borderlands 2 and TPS and how they affect pet action skills. So let's start with Borderlands 2 where we have Exton's Saber Turret and Gage's Death Trap. There's also Zero's Decoy, but that's invincible and doesn't deal any damage, so it's irrelevant for this video. Going over class mod passives first, keep in mind that I excluded things that obviously cannot affect friendly AI such as Salvador's ammo regen. Zero's Killer class mod boosts team crit damage and has no effect on either the turret or Death Trap. By the way, the only ability Death Trap has that I observed being able to score a crit was 1-2 Boom. Exton's Gunner class mod boosts team fire rate, which does affect the turret but not Death Trap. The damage ticks per second of his shock beam and the stairs stay the same. The Sweetheart class mod of Gage boosts team max health and doesn't affect either of the two. The same goes for Maya's Nurse class mod, which provides passive team health regeneration. Exton's Tactician and Legendary Ranger class mods boost team shield recharge rate and delay. If Death Trap uses a shield with sharing is caring, he does benefit from those boosts, but the turret obviously doesn't because it has no shield. Gage's Catalyst class mod increases team damage over time and does affect both the turret and Death Trap. The turret's nuke procs a fire damage over time, and Death Trap's DOTs from the stair Make It Sparkle and 1-2 Boom are boosted as well. So I guess if you use a mod that increases the damage over time of those abilities by a few million percent, this is relevant information for you. Finally, Zero's Shot class mod boosts team accuracy, which affects the turret but not Death Trap since his shock beam and the stair are locked onto enemies. Next, let's go over skills that affect teammates. Maya's Restoration can heal both the turret and Death Trap by shooting at them. Elated works with both as well, however it's still based off of Maya's max HP, so it barely does anything for them percentage wise. And lastly, healing trails from transfusions, sweet release or the share a me do seek out the turret and Death Trap as well. Now you might be curious if all of those boosts also affect the second turret from Gemini, since that's not affected by Exton's skill Sentry. However, everything works as it should and all of the team boosts that apply to the first turret also apply to the second one. Now let's move on to the pre-sequel. In TPS there are Wilhelm's Wolf and Saint and Jack's Digijax. Saint, however, doesn't actually have any hit points, doesn't deal any damage and is more like a flying texture, so we can ignore it. Claptrap also has several different pets, but since they're all invincible, a lot of team boosts are irrelevant for them as well. His turret minion trap might be affected by some, but I'll mention that when I get to those team boosts. Starting with class mod passives again, there's Wilhelm's Mech class mod that boosts team shield recharge rate and delay. That applies to Digijax with You Have My Shield, but it does not apply to Wolf's shield, presumably because it only affects equipable shields. Claptrap's Bro Trap and Aurelia's Mistress class mods have team health regeneration, which applies to both Wolf and the Digijax. Jack's Role Model class mod adds team max health, which has no effect on either Wolf or the Jax. Then Jack's Protagonist class mod increases team shield capacity, which does affect both of them. The CEO class mod of Jack has two team passives, accuracy and crit damage. Accuracy doesn't affect Wolf or Digijax since their shots don't have randomized spreads, even with diversity. This one may affect Minion Trap as Zero's team accuracy also boosts Exton's Saber Turret. At least I hope it does because that thing acts like it has 600 stacks of Anarchy just without the damage boost. As for the crit damage, it does not affect Digijax and presumably it doesn't affect Minion Trap either. Just like the Saber Turret, Digijax and Minion Trap deal the same damage on body hits and criticals. As for Wolf, he cannot score crits because his shots would require a true universal crit spot to test, which doesn't exist in TPS aside from the Eye of EOS, which can't be targeted by Wolf. Blightbot, Punkbot and Clone Trap most likely cannot score crits either. Now let's get to the more complicated stuff in TPS, skills. TPS has a much wider variety of team-related skills than Borderlands 2, and I wasn't able to confirm everything with complete certainty. First, we have Jack's skill Supply and Demand, which provides constant health regeneration based on Jack's current health. This does apply to Wolf and Digijax. Claptrap's skill Maniacal Laughter grants health regeneration that stacks every time he deals damage over time. It also applies to both action skills. Aurelia's Magic Bullet creates a healing nova when you score a critical hit. Claptrap's You're Going to Love Me and It's a Trap card both create healing novas as well, the former on a kill and the latter when his shield gets depleted. However, none of these novas have any effect on Wolf or Digijax. Now moving on to Wilhelm's skills, things get a little more vague. His skill Zero Hour creates an area on the ground which provides health regeneration to any teammate standing inside of it. If a Digijax stands in it, it does not get health regen. Now since Wolf flies, I'm pretty sure there's no way for him to receive any benefits from Zero Hour either. Overcharge grants several temporal bonuses to nearby teammates, including increased fire rate. This doesn't seem to have any effect on them though. The only pet of Claptrap that actually shoots anything is Minion Trap and it might be affected, but I also think that's unlikely. Energize restores a portion of the shield of nearby allies, but it doesn't seem to target Wolf or Digijax. Finally, Hazmat Containment System grants damage reduction to an element while Wilhelm is affected by a DOT. This one was annoying to test because at first I tried to use duels, but as it turns out they have special rules for certain skills, including team boosts from characters that don't even participate in the duel, so everything just didn't work out. But after finding an enemy with an elemental gun to shoot at my pets, I got a result of it applying to both Wolf and Digijax. There's one more skill that doesn't provide a team boost but benefits from teammates. Claptrap's All the Things Are Awesome. The bonuses Claptrap receives from it increase with each teammate in the game, but friendly AI doesn't increase them. It seems pretty obvious, but I just wanted to mention it anyway. That's all about team boosts in Borderlands 2 and the pre-sequel. If you've got any questions, feel free to ask in the comments, and as always, thanks for watching. See ya everyone.